G'day. My last few videos have all been a bit doom and gloom. Not this one. I've got a new toy and I'm going to have fun telling you all about it. And yes, there will be an unboxing. Let's get into it. So for those that know me, or for those that have been watching this channel for a little while, you'll know that I like my photography and making videos and technology and cameras. And you may know that my main camera that I film and shoot on is a Panasonic Lumix G9, which is what I'm filming on right now. It's a Micro Four Thirds lens based camera. And that all started with the camera I had before that, is this Olympus OM-D EM5mk3. It was great getting into the system. A pretty good photography camera. But as I got into video, it did limit me a little bit, in that it was only HD, not 4K, and didn't have a microphone input. And as I've used it recently, I've had a little bit of trouble with it. The focusing not quite working, accessing the app on your phone would drop out quite a bit. And if I was in a situation where I needed the flash, just a pop-up flash, if I had a long lens like this one, the lens itself could actually make a shadow in your photo. Now, to get over that, I did buy a generic flash for the Lumix, but I really couldn't get it to work well. Now, about a year ago, Olympus announced the OM-D EM5 Mark III, and I was really interested in that. It had a high resolution sensor, it did 4K, it had a microphone jack, and it came with an external flash included. It is about $1,700 or $1,800 Australian, so I really couldn't justify it. But I have been keeping an eye on it. I have seen it down in the low $1,600, but I recently saw it on eBay. Now, the eBay store of a major retailer, so it wasn't going to be something dodgy, for $1,300. So that's almost a $500 saving. And I recently paid off the Lumix, and considering I've got a little bit of a cancer death sentence over my head, my wife said she was happy for me to splurge, buy myself a new toy. So here we are, the Olympus OM-D EM5 Mark III. I'm going to have a look at what's in the box, and then we'll give it a bit of a test run today as well. I do note that it's in a few spaces it's got Australian version on the box. Now, I'm not sure what the Australian version has that versions in the rest of the world doesn't. I know with the Lumix, there was a difference in frame rates. America got all the NTSC frame rates, Europe got the PEL formats, and Australia, we got both. So that might be what the difference is here, but clearly marked the Australian version. So I don't want to make this video too boring, so I'll try and get through this quickly, and we'll see what is in the box. Brochure, some more paperwork, this has got a bit of weight in it. I'm not sure what this is going to be. It's got a bit of weight in it because it's a multi-page, multilingual, heavy book that I might not read. Packaging. Power cord. Strap. Really gone off the straps. I prefer a little, just a wrist strap on my cameras now. USB cord. It's the old style micro USB. It'd be nice if it was USB-C, but we'll run with that. A pouch. Battery charger. Battery. Flash. Now that is a lot smaller than I expected. That's the external flash that comes with the camera. It is a lot smaller than I was expecting, but at least it is an external flash and it is adjustable, so you can point it to bounce off the walls instead of pointing directly. Yeah. And that will raise up a little bit higher off the camera, so you hopefully can avoid shadows from the lenses. And that's probably what the pouch is for too, I'm guessing. So that's that box. Bit of plastic. And a bag. And in that bag is some bubble wrap. And in the bubble wrap is my new Olympus OM-D EM5 Mark III. Let's just take a quick look. So I've got a microphone port, and I didn't think this came with a headphone jack. Maybe it's a remote, so I'm not sure what that one is. Then we've got USB and micro HDMI, so that's the ports on that side. I've got the memory card slot, single UHS 2 SD card slot, some nice dials on the top there for getting your adjustments, flippy screen. It does feel very, very plasticky, but as long as it does the job. And the strap holders, might have to get rid of those, because listen to that, if I'm making a video, they're going to rattle around and become annoying. So I'll have to work out a way of dealing with those. Let's get the battery and we'll see if there's any charge in this. So battery goes in. I wonder, is it the same battery that comes in the older? Oh, maybe it is. It looks like, if I put it in the right way, yes. I didn't even realize that. I didn't even think about it, but my existing batteries from the EM10 Mark II work on the new camera. Pretty excited about that. But just out of curiosity's sake, let's see how much charge comes in the included battery if I put it in the right way. Okay, so the included battery's got about half a charge on it. That's okay. So there's a few things there that we've got to do to set it up. So I might throw a lens on it, throw a memory card in it, and give this a bit of a test run. Okay. We have lens. We have screen. So I'm in program mode, so it's, you know, the next step down from full auto. So if I just press record, okay, let's get that to focus. So there we are, the first video image out of the Olympus OM-D EM5 Mark III. I don't have an external microphone, so you're hearing me just through the built-in microphones. How does that look? Anyway, so I'll play around with this a bit more. The battery's flashing at me, so I'm not sure I'll get much more out of this. I'll have a bit more of a play around with the settings, and we'll take it out, give it a bit of a test run, and go from there. I'll see you soon. Okay, let's take a look at this external flash that comes with the OM-D EM5 Mark III. Just slide him into the hot shoe, turn him on, So I've got a little flashing flash symbol on the screen to tell me that it's on. And as you can see, I can adjust the angle. And we have flash. What did that picture look like? There we go. It's a picture of you out there in YouTube land. Cool bananas.
So it's a good camera so far?
There's another reason why I was keen to stick with Olympus, and that's one of my favourite features that they have in their cameras. Even the base OM-D EM10, and that's live composite. I'm excited that it's in this EM5 Mk3. Live composite is similar to bulb mode, but it allows you to capture things like star trails and traffic lights. And one of my favourite pictures that I've ever taken was with the EM10. And this features star trails and traffic tail lights and headlights. So I'm really excited to be able to get out and do that again with the better EM5 Mk3. So I've been taking a few test shots around the house, and I've also put on the Lumix 15mm prime. How compact does this look with that little lens? All right, I've had a little bit of a look through the owner's manual. It looks like I'm going to have to do a firmware update, a bit of a Google search. So I think we're a couple of firmware versions behind, so I need to work out how to do that. The other thing, that little pouch that we got, it is for the flash. So got some really nice images using the flash just around the house. So nice that we have a little pouch for that. Yeah, it's a nice little pouch there for the flash. So I'll find a home for that in the camera bag. So I'm going to do the firmware update. I'll play around a bit more, get my settings right, and then we might go outside and do some more test shots. All right, back soon. Okay, I'm still getting to know my way around my new Olympus OM-D EM5 Mk3. Back when this camera was first released, some of the reviewers did okay in low light, which was pretty surprising for the little Micro Four Thirds sensor. So how does this look? I've got the Lumix 12-60 f/2.8 lens on the camera. I'm in manual video mode with the shutter set to 50 and the frame rate set to 24. In the little flip out screen, she doesn't look too bad. What about the audio? I haven't brought my plug-in Rode microphone, so this is just the audio from the built-in microphones on the Olympus. How do we sound? How do we look? So I am standing under a street lamp in the local park. So I've played around with this for a little bit. I've updated the firmware, so we're on version 1.2 now. I've customized some of my settings, and I've found a couple of little interesting points. So right now I'm in the movie mode, and interestingly, you can't adjust the ISO in movie mode. It's locked into auto, which seems to be going all right at the moment. But if I did want to manually adjust the ISO, I'd have to go to one of the other manual modes, probably shutter priority, and set the ISO there, and then press the record button. Even though all my other manual adjustments are available in the movie mode, just not ISO. Bit strange. Another thing that I found, which I thought was surprising, a little bit frustrating, the cinema 4K mode, which is the 17:9 4K mode. So it's a higher resolution. It's fixed at 24 frames per second, So I can understand, because there's more data in that stream, that they can't go higher than 24. But what's interesting is that it is exactly 24 frames per second. All your other modes, when you set it to 24, it's 23.97, which is pretty common. That's what the Lumix is, that's what my GoPro is. I think that's what the phones are as well. And that's pretty standard, 23.97 frames per second. But in the cinema 4K mode on the Olympus, it is exactly 24. If you change it to the other 4K modes, in 16:9 ratio, which is what I'm filming at now, it is 23.97, just like all the other cameras. So if you're using both modes in a project, try to match up that speed, even though there's not much difference, what you're probably going to notice is the audio pitch will change a little bit, and you might get some stuttering if you're filming something with fast motion in it, just because of that little bit of difference. So I thought that was interesting. Anyway, I'm going to keep playing with this camera. I've taken a few still shots while I've been out walking, so if they've turned out, I'll put some of those up here as well. So I'll keep playing around with the camera. If you want more reviews or more info, comparisons, or anything about the Olympus OM-D EM5 Mark III, leave me a comment. If not, you'll just see, well, you probably won't even notice, but some of my videos will be recorded with this from now on. Anyway, I'll leave it there. Thanks for watching. Hopefully this nighttime footage is okay. Thanks for watching. I'll see you in the next video. Cheers.